Hi, I'm Ken DeSessa from Revelwood. Thanks for joining me today. This video is about dashboarding in Workday Adaptive Planning. Dashboards are a great part of adaptive planning. So let me go ahead and take you into the dashboard function and show you a little bit about them. When you first come into dashboards, you're presented with a number of tiles that you've created that help you organize your dashboards any way you'd like. Let's go ahead and go into this company summary right now. As you can see, one of the tabs we've created within this company summary is just some basic information. So you could communicate with people via the dashboard if you choose to, put links into these dashboards if you choose to. It's really up to you how you use them. First thing I thought I'd do is just step you through a couple of the dashboards just to give you a flavor for what they might look like. Now, these first series of dashboards are very finance-oriented, finance data-oriented, as you can see. But you can create any kind of dashboard with any kind of data that you've brought into the system. For example, we've got CRM data here. We've got order data here. Sales, and even production data here as well. So there's really no limit as to what you can do as long as you bring the data into the adaptive planning system. Now you'll notice up here we have some selectors. So within these dashboards, we have drop downs where we can select the dates we want to look at, the levels within our company we want to look at. We can select currency if we like. We can select the version that we're looking at. Maybe it's our budget, maybe it's our forecast, etc. So we can do things like that. You can also put this into what I would call PowerPoint mode simply by clicking this little camera up here. So if you wanted to focus people in on a particular thing as you're going through a presentation, maybe you can do that. You can also snapshot and create schedules to snapshot these particular dashboards out to individuals as well. So there's a whole bunch of things you can do with these dashboards. Change dates within the individual dashboards. You can download a specific image, those sorts of things. But the real power in these dashboards becomes in your ability to actually drill back into data from them. So for example, I'm looking at this particular revenue chart here. If I click on this individual bar, I'm presented with all the different dimensions associated with that data. So for this revenue bar, I can say, well, I want to look at revenue by location, let's say. So I've drilled down from that revenue number into my various locations of my organization. Now maybe I want to look at Great Britain and look at the customers that are buying from them. I can see customer 5 is buying from them. I may want to say, well, what product is customer 5 buying? And I can drill down into that particular product. At any point in time, quite frankly, I can change and drill into something else. So I can see that customer 1 is the biggest customer in the USA. So it's really, you know, unlimited ability to actually go into these dimensions and drill into them to investigate what's happening. But you could also get very granular in what you want to look at. For example, I can do explore data on that same revenue bar, and it actually takes me back into the actual revenue sheet with all the detailed information and where it's coming from. So as you can see, here's all the different information, and I have various drop downs. I can look and slice this data any way I like to at this particular point. Okay. Another aspect of dashboards, which I think people really like, quite frankly, is the ability to combine dashboards with planning data. So if I go into this budget entry tile, and specifically into workforce here, I can see what I've done here is I've combined visualizations around my workforce data with an actual planning sheet for workforce planning. So I would actually be able to go in here and change the data within these particular sheets if I chose to do so. So that's a unique aspect of adaptive planning dashboards that people really seem to like. Now what I'd like to do is show you how to actually create a dashboard, because I think it's really important that you see just how easy it is to do. We'll just click on this new button. We'll give it a name. We'll go to edit, and now we have our canvas that we're going to build our dashboard on. So you'll notice there's just two things here. These are all the visualizations that we can use within our dashboards. Okay, and this little file drawer is important because it's what contains all our data. Now keep in mind that it's not just about general ledger data in adaptive planning. It's really any data you can bring into the system or calculate within the system. So as you can see here, we have all kinds of custom data sheet that we've created, metrics, key performance indicators, etc. Okay. So the first thing I want to do to actually create a dashboard is just drag a visualization onto the canvas, pick a piece of data, drag that data onto the visualization, and then do a little formatting and breaking down of that data. And here are all my options over here. Now, we're not going to get into a lot of the various formatting options. I'm going to show you how to break down this data because it's just showing me all operating expenses right now. So let's go ahead and break that down by location. And there you have it. A dashboard based on our locations of our operating expenses. So it's pretty easy to do. Let's go ahead and show you a little bit, another one, just an example. Maybe I want to create a KPI. That's a common chart. And just select, typically we'd pop a metric into it, gross margin. Again, pretty straightforward to do. And I'll just do one more for you so you can continue to get the idea. Maybe we want to do a line chart. Let's go ahead and put our revenue in there. Again, let's go ahead and break it down. You can do that one again by location. So now here's the great thing about the dashboards. As soon as we've completed a dashboard, hit done, all the data is now accessible to me in and through this dashboard. So I can click on any part of this dashboard and have all my dimensions exposed to me and drill into the dashboard like I showed a little earlier, or I could explore data. So it's that quick and easy, and the system is well connected together. Dashboards are a great way to convey performance data and monitor your business. Today's video showed you just how effective Workday Adaptive Planning Dashboards can be. If you'd like to learn more, subscribe to our YouTube channel for additional videos, and please visit us at revelwood.com.